excited to be here. My agent called me. He said, Brian, you've been on Letterman, you've been on Ferguson. You want to work LA or Vegas? I said, no. How about a freezing restaurant near the airport? Is that doable? He said, I don't think we can do it. I said, make some calls, make the magic happen. Pull in some favors, do whatever you have to do. So I'd like to thank the Make-A-Wish Foundation for making this dream a reality. Thank you. I gotta say, you guys are awesome. Thank you for laughing and coming out for a good time on New Year's. Because a lot of New Yorkers, it's been a rough year. People have an attitude in New York. Even the people that are supposed to help you. I flew into Kennedy. I went up to the information guy. I said, excuse me, is there a bathroom around here? And the guy goes, you want the closest one? What are you supposed to say to that question? No, I kind of like to drag out the discomfort as long as I can, actually. Yeah, you got anything with a cab ride or a connecting flight involved? Oh, sure, a lot of people take the first bathroom that comes along, but me, I like to shop around. It's a big decision. I'd like to sample 6 or 7 before I commit. You hear weird things in New York. You hear weird things all the time, right? As if flying isn't stressful enough, getting on a plane is a nightmare. That's why the pilots have to be extra soothing when they come on. That's my favorite part of flying. They all come on, they have that Midwestern accent. Good afternoon, everybody. This is your pilot speaking. I'm always wondering why they have to say that. Who else is going to grab the microphone in the middle of a flight? Yeah, this is Tommy down here in the baggage hold. There's a blue Samsonite down here. It's leaking some kind of green liquid. Somebody get down here fast because I'm scared. Oh, you got to be cool. You got to be smooth, right? Good afternoon, everybody. This is your pilot speaking. We are third in line for takeoff here. We got good skies ahead of us. We just have a few announcements. We'll remind that there's no smoking on the plane. That includes the lavatory. And we know you have travel options. We appreciate you choosing to include us in your travel plans here today. You got 45 years of flight experience up here in the cockpit. Which is good, because look out the plane, you might notice one of the wings is falling off. You know, so it looks like we're going to get in a little early today. That's kind of nice. A much steeper angle.
That is the coolest thing, right? That is the perfect accent for that job. You never hear a guy with a New York accent coming out of the cockpit, because that wouldn't sound nearly as soothing coming from the pilot.
Yeah, good afternoon, everybody. Yeah, how you doing? My name is Fast Eddie. Yeah, that's right. I'll be your pilot today if anybody's not happy about that. Yeah, join the friggin' club on that one. 25 years of this business, you'd think they'd start giving me some of the good routes. Anyways, listen up, people. I got a couple announcements. I'm only going to say this once. There's no smoking on the plane, no smoking in a bathroom either. You know why that is? It's because the bathroom is actually part of the airplane. That seems to come as a big shock to some of you people back there. And the mere fact that I have to point that out is the reason I hate this job. Once you get in the air, you look out of the plane, you know you're gonna see water. And that's where you're gonna be if anybody tries anything during this flight. I'm serious, people, I'm in no mood today. Maybe that's a little too early for that joke. Anyways. You got these customs forms here, you can fill them out, not fill them out. I don't care if you fold them up and wear them like a sailor hat, I couldn't care less. You got 21 weeks of sobriety up here in the cockpit. So you all know it's one day at a time, people, one day at a time. We appreciate you choosing to fly with us today, even though we all know you had no other options. Only 3 airlines left, and one of them is Qantas. So what are you going to do, ride a seahorse across the Atlantic? We're 5th in line on the runway here. So I'm going to see if I can cut one of these guys off, okay? Hang on tight and enjoy the flight.
Oh, thank you. Yeah.
Now, the New York accent's not the sexiest accent. It's not like Spanish, which is cool.
turn on a Spanish soap opera. Everyone's cool and dramatic. Ever watch one of those 2 in the morning? El punto de grafía del mundo de Trapanella, something easy. El filio mio de Cinco de Mayo, mucho dinero ayudado. Feliz Navidad, uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, el pollo loco. Huevos rancheros, yo quiero Taco Bell. That is awesome. It took 4 years of Spanish. Anybody take Spanish? We all took Spanish. We studied Spanish. We passed Spanish. One thing we didn't learn, how to speak Spanish. That's it. I can pass any Spanish test. Give me a Spanish test right now, get a 98 on it. You kick me out of a van in Tijuana, I won't be able to find a bathroom, okay? El baño. El baño? 4 years of Spanish. You know what I can say in Spanish? El gato tiene hambre. The cat is hungry. It's the only thing I know how to say. I keep waiting to use that. It has never come up once. I'm waiting. One day I'm going to be sitting in a cafe in Peru and a puma attacks me. I am going to be ready. El gato tiene hambre. Yeah, thank God you're here, man. You'll save our village. I am half Jewish and half Irish Catholic. So, exactly. So I'm drunk, but I feel very guilty. Okay, so that's something. This is what I do as a shore. Why stop there? You also want a guy who's smart but not nerdy, caring but not needy, affectionate but not clingy, protective but not possessive, emotional but not neurotic, funny but not a clown, dominant but not domineering, and in control but not controlling. No problem. Coming right up, girls. You want it all, don't you, ladies? You also like a bit of a bad boy, too. A man with an edge, a little bit of mystery, even a little hint of danger. Yeah. Who loves kids? So let's review. Did you get all that, guys? It's simple. How hard can it be? We just gotta be strong but sensitive, tough but tender, masculine but gentle, and manly but vulnerable. Because apparently what a woman wants is a gay football coach. Mystery solved. That's an unlikely combo. This job is okay, though, because there are certain jobs you can't make one mistake. One mistake, you're all over the news. If you're an airline pilot, one mistake, you can't do that. Comedian, what's the worst thing that can happen? I'm not funny. That's not going to make the news. You're not going to turn on the news at the end of the comedy show. Horror at a local comedy show tonight. As witnesses say, an evening that began with laughter ended in tragedy when a bad comedian took the stage, leaving audience members searching for answers.
Yeah, I was standing over by the bathroom, and usually the comedians here are pretty good, but you know, this guy goes on, and right away I knew something was wrong. This guy didn't even look funny, you know, and I was one of the lucky ones. I was sitting in the back, I was able to get out in time, you know. Some of the people up front, they was trapped. There was nothing you could do, it all happened so fast. I thought you see something like that, it really makes you want to go home and hug your kids, you know?
Some are blaming management for their response to the tragedy.
They told us we could not leave until we had paid our checks. Everyone was screaming, my wife was crying, let us out, this guy is not funny. Please, let us out. His jokes were not well written. He did not have a unique comedic point of view.
No one should have to see something like that. This did not have to happen. This did not have to happen.
Oh, thank you. That's so sweet. Well, we're very lucky to live here in America because we don't have any disasters. I was just overseas. And I love the BBC, that's my favorite. The BBC, you ever watch the BBC? They cover the famine, civil war, genocide stories, and every story is exactly the same. They got that one reporter that comes on the news. A young child wanders the streets of a mud-cracked hillside. His tear-stained face and the gunfire tells the story. For a tragedy has taken hold here that has crippled this once peaceful village, a tragedy that appears to have no end. Hakimi is a local tribesman.
They always have a local guy they have to translate for. I don't know what I will do. Things are very bad here now. This was a peaceful place to live, but we are terrified. How will we feed our families?
Anger has turned to fear here. The provisional government seems helpless to stop the bloodshed, and if supplies do not arrive soon, all may be lost. But there are no winners or losers here. Just a sad people staring into an uncertain future. Brian Kittle, CNN, Sri Lanka. Who the hell is that guy? He's on every story. Except he's never on the local news. And you know why, folks? Because we don't have any of that crap in America. They got famine, civil war, genocide in other countries. We had a doorman strike in my building. And people freaked out. A doorman. People in other countries don't even have doors. Not to mention a guy whose only job it is to open it for you. That's why they never let the BBC guy cover the local news. Because a doorman strike would not nearly have the same tragic ring to it. An old man shuffles the lobby of a posh Upper West Side apartment building, unable to get outside. For a strike has taken hold here that has pitted neighbor against neighbor in a struggle to survive. A strike that appears to have no end. Mr. Rosenberg has lived here for 35 years.
I don't know what the hell to do. You come down, you can't get out the damn door here. I pay my rent, when are they gonna settle this thing? I come in, they're yelling, they're picketing, they're screaming, oi, settle it, damn it.
Anger has turned to fear here. The strike has affected everything here. An order of Chinese food arrives. But there is no one there to greet him. Some of these upper middle class yuppies have not eaten takeout in weeks. The human cost is incalculable. Even the delivery man is angry. Unga tao, unga tao, unga tao. Bata unga tao, unga tao, unga tao.
I don't know what I will do. Things are very bad. How will we feed our families? Right, it'll CNN Park Avenue.